Welcome, everybody, to the Around the World Music Series 2021. We're so happy you were able to join us. My name is Jeff Ingram. I'm the Executive Director of Standing Rock Cultural Arts. We're a nonprofit art and education organization based in downtown Kent, Ohio. And the Around the World Music Series is one of our premier programs where we feature a different country, their music, and their culture. And this series was conceived and brought to you by ethnomusicologist David Bonagnani, who you'll see in just a moment. But we really are happy to premiere Romanian music today and the Taragot instrument with Gheorghe. We're very excited to have him here. We welcome him here. And I hope you enjoy the show. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is David Bonagnani, and I'm the curator of the Around the World music series. And we do our best to present for you musics from around the world that maybe many people have never had a chance to hear before. Romanian music, and in particular the Taragot instrument, is something that maybe you've never had a chance to hear. So what we're going to have today is a virtual concert, about an hour in length, by one of its premier exponents, Mr. Gheorghe Trambitas from Parma, Ohio. And these concerts will be aired in virtual form from January through May of 2022. And you can look forward to concerts by master musicians from three different cultures. The first one will be Romanian music. And we'll welcome Mr. Trambitas.
But first of all, can you tell me what is your name and where do you come from?
My name is Gheorghe Trambitas. We call in Romania, they call me like Gheorghe or Ghiță. Ghiță is like Gheorghe here. And I'm coming from middle of the country. It's the name of the village. It's Beclean, and it's by Făgăraş. It's in the middle of the country. So I came here invited from Gigi Stella and Leni Ardelean from Kenton in 1990 in July for the concert. We are a big group of musicians, dancers, singers, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't believe it was 31 years ago.
It's been a while.
Yeah.
What is the name of the instrument that you play?
The name is Taragot.
Taragot.
It's not a Romanian instrument, it's a Hungarian, they call Tarogato. It's very old, probably made in 18th century.
18th century?
Yes.
That particular instrument?
Yes.
It's very old.
I think they used, this instrument was prohibited in Hungarian during the Rákóczi Revolution.
Mm-hmm.
1892, something like that.
Mm-hmm. And when did you start learning how to play it?
Oh, the story is I started to play accordion when I was 7, and I started playing the saxophone when I was 14, because it was very hard to find it, and I love these sounds of this instrument. I bought a soprano sax because it was very hard to find this instrument. So finally, I found this instrument in 1992. And I gave up, I mean, I didn't give up the saxophone, but it's what I was like it. I got from Borrow the Music in 1992.
Mm-hmm. And when did you join the band?
The band?
That came over here.
Oh, that was from 1983, I think. I played on that group.
And what was the name of the group?
Plaiurile Bursei. That's all group, dancer, musician, mm-hmm. Plaiurile Bursei from Brasov.
A whole performing group.
Yeah.
And do they still perform?
I don't think so, no.
No? Do you perform with other groups?
Oh, yeah. I played with Transylvania band. I have a group Tricoloro in Virginia. I have a group Hora in Chicago. Yeah, I played with a lot of groups.
And so, what's the one that you play with the most?
The Transylvania group. I play probably from 1990 to 2003.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, they are in Cleveland.
Oh, wonderful, yeah. Wonderful. And are there many Taragot players in the U.S. or in Ohio?
In U.S., I know are It's a very, very famous musician which played with Zamfir, Gheorghe Zamfir. His name is Pavel Cebzan. He's a wonderful Taragot player, mm-hmm. and clarinet also. Mm-hmm. He was the best clarinet player in, he came from Banat. Mm-hmm. Also, it's a John Stonash, which also he fixed the instruments. He's in Chicago also. Mm-hmm. And let me think about it. Oh, it's a friend of mine from Virginia, but he's not Romania, he's from Czechoslovakia, George Petran. He's, let me think about it. I don't think if I know anybody in the United States except those. Mm-hmm. But in Romania, there are a lot of Taragot players. And I would like to mention the best Taragot in the world, Luca Novak. We were friends. We were talked to the phone a couple times a year. He passed away of AD this year in February. Mm-hmm. But if you go on YouTube, he's the best. Mm-hmm. I don't think if anybody, nobody play like him, and I don't think if anybody is going to be born in next 100 years to play like him. And also, the most famous in Romania was Dumitru Fărcaș. He was a little bit more famous because, but he didn't play so fast, you know. People love him. He was very popular and he got a very classic sound. But for me, Luca Novak was the best. But if you ask Romanian people, they say, oh, you like Dumitru Fărcaș. He was like a Kenny G, Dumitru Fărcaș.
Kenny G. Yeah, one more question. Where did you get your training? Did you have a mentor or someone taught you how to play the tarago?
No, it's a long story. My uncle, Nicolae, Trambitas, he was oldest brother to my father. He teach me to the accordion. He played all kinds of instruments: accordion, violin, trumpet, caval. He played all kinds of instruments. He didn't teach just me. He teach my brother, because my brother came in the same time in United States with the group. He played the saxophone. I'm sorry, he died in a car accident in 1995. But we are so close. Mm-hmm. So he teach my brother, he teach all my cousins. The people in a village, which are the... It's not a big village, just maximum 500 houses. Mm-hmm. And he teach every kid which try to... which loves to the music. Mm-hmm. So he teach me, and after I go to school in Brasov, it was about 30 miles away from my village, So after I graduated the high school, I was three years in a music school, but for the saxophone. And this is all my training. And I rehearsed a lot, and because I played a lot of weddings and christening parties in Romania. You know, when you played a lot, you mm-hmm. automatically you can play fast and stuff like that.
Get better and better.
Because, the Romanian wedding on that time, believe me or not, we played from 5 o'clock p.m. to 3 in the morning. Mm-hmm. It was a big wedding, so we played each weekend because it was not a DJ or stuff, you know, DJ.
Live music,
yeah. Excellent. Now...
Everybody gets a DJ.
We don't blame the virus, we blame DJ because we don't have a lot to play. You know, if you want to do a wedding party, if you have a big screen TV, you can do it with your phone, whatever you want.
Yeah, that's so true. So true.
Yeah.
Can we get a close-up of the instrument? The camera's right here.
Sure.
Bring it closer.
Sure. And if you want to show them off, please.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and... this one, and go ahead, bring it
the
down.
The mouthpiece.
There we go, right there. Spin it.
It's a Selmer C1 Star, if anybody wants to know. Mm-hmm. Selmer 1 Star, it's a, I'll show you, because you cannot play with the original mouthpiece of the Taragot, I tried, but. Mm-hmm. So what I did, cut off, so you know how the clarinet, it's got like a little piece
it's
of
a
here, the
cut single, off. Single reed, right?
Single reed. Mm-hmm. The guy on lay machine, he took some, for this diameter, he took some material out, and it's a little washer in there, Ebony. I have the drawing on my phone, so you can show the people which are interested exactly the measurements and everything. Mm-hmm. I'll show you later. Mm-hmm. And I want to show you, probably it's one of biggest secrets. Mm-hmm. Inside of the, if you look, inside of the room of the mouthpiece, mm-hmm. see I put some like epoxy mm-hmm. to shorter the...
to make it fit tighter.
Fit tighter, yeah. Mm-hmm. Because you if you do that, you blow easier, and when you play fast, that helps you.
Nice.
Because the room is shorter than supposed to be. Mm-hmm. But you need to be in a tune, you need to take out because it's filled up here. Mm-hmm. You cannot play here because you are over dub. So I pull a little bit more here to mm-hmm. be in a tune. Mm-hmm. That's because it's this. Mm-hmm. So automatically the sound is going sharper. So,
is this pipe tape?
This is a Teflon tape
for pipe.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I use this one because sometimes you know from the cork, it's moving like this, and I lose the air. That's what I'm doing this.
Tell us about the fingering of the instrument.
Okay, the difference between the soprano sax and taragot is just the F sharp on the soprano sax, you take like this. On taragot, you take like this. And also, on soprano sax, you have two octaves. One octave to the saxophone. Over here, you have two. So the second one you use, so the first one you use, let me show you. See, no octave now.
Step back just a little.
Yeah. So it's not octave now, so. Now the first octave, and now the second. Sorry.
Ready? Okay.
Go ahead.
Hello, everybody. I'd like to say thank you very much to Mr. Badaniani because he invited me here, and thank you for the opportunity. Thanks a lot.
Wonderful. And you're going to start with a song?
Yeah.
What song?
Should I say what song is it? Mm-hmm. It's the name is Invertita. It's from my region. It's usually it's played in all middle of the country or Transylvania. It's this tempo is like tam 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 tam. So what I supposed to say? I ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to start to play Invertita from Făgăraş. Făgăraş and Sibiu. hello, everybody. The first song is it's called Invertita, and it's from the Făgăraş and Sibiu region. It's like, I was in the middle of Transylvania, of the Romanian country. So I'm going to play two of those together. Now I change the mouthpiece, the sound is going to be a little bit more sharp. We use that because the next sound is going to be from Banat. It's a place in close to Yugoslavia, it's a northwest of the country. If you go there, you cannot imagine how many Taragot saxophone players. They play so fast. I think nobody plays so fast like them in the world. In Moldavia also, we have a very good trumpet player which play fast like that in Moldavia. So what I try to say, I played a lot of weddings in Romania, and they were not like here. Or like easy 500 people probably, because when somebody got married, a young couple in a village, they invite almost everybody. And the gift to the young couple was a lot of money, almost the salary for 1 month. And we made a good money in Romania, because to be honest with you, how much money I got to one wedding was like an engineer getting a month. But was not a DJ on that time. It was hard to play because we played 10 hours in a party center. But before we get there, we played on the street. Everybody follow the music. We go with the first to the grown house. We go to pick up the godparents from their house. And after that, we pick up the bride. And after that, we go to church, and from church, go to the party, big party, and a lot of drinks, you know, Romanian style. Okay, so next song is going to be from Banat. It's something which Luca Novak, the best Taragot player in the world, he played. Sound they we call Brum Bănățean is from Banat, and it's very close, the tempo it's very close to Invertita, like pam 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 pam. I'm sorry, I don't have an orchestra with me, so okay. The first Tarogato player which bring this instrument in Romania, his name was Luce Jovica. So he was on the World War First, and he played this instrument during the war. He was in a war and he played this instrument, and it's a story. The German people, they were in another side, when they hear him play, they cry. So think about it. You cry, you hear another side, how nice play, and after that, you killed each other. Yeah. So, yeah, this is the story. By Luce Jovica, he was the first one who bring this instrument in Romania. 1960. The next sound, it's from Banat also, they call Joc de Doi. I cannot play fast like a musician there because, you know, but they play very, very fast. This is very fast in Banat, in the region of Caransebeș and Timișoara. A lot of saxophone and Taragot players, so they are wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, the next sound, it's a song which I really like it. When I was a kid, I was watching the movie, a classic movie, Romeo and Juliet, and I really like that sound and how it sounds on Taragot. So I'm going to play for you. Ladies and gentlemen, the next sound is from north of the Transylvania. We call from Salaj, the Salaj. And I'm going to play with the orchestra. It's about 20 musicians, around 20 musician orchestra, professional from Cluj. Ovidiu Barteș orchestra. Ovidiu Barteș is a very, it's amazing violin player. Ovidiu Barteș is the best in Romania, very famous, and he plays very good. So I recorded the CD with his band in 2006 in Cluj, Romania. Doina from Cebea, we call Doina de la Cebea, it's from Maramureș, it's a north of Transylvania. It sounds like spiritual, it's hard to play because you don't play with the instrument, you need to play with your soul, so depending how you're feeling on that time. Nobody can play the same, so if I play now and I go next day to the wedding and I play, it's not going to sound the same. It's something which you need to feel it when you play. So sometimes people which lost somebody or something like that, they are crying when they hear this sound, when they listen to Doina. Yes, the next sound, it's Rara from Rupea. It's from my region, from Făgăraș. And it's not a really fast sound, but a lot of people, they dance on to the weddings and festivals, christening party. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, the last song for today, it's a song which is never missing to the Romanian party. I'm talking about weddings, christening party, birthday party. The name is, are two songs together, Mulți ani trăiască, and La mulți ani cu sănătate, you're going to see a different tempo. So first it's Mulți ani trăiască, like many, many years. And the next one, which everybody needs now in our world, it's La mulți ani cu sănătate, many, many years in the future with health and happiness. I hope that's going to happen. Și în limba română. Deci cântecele pe care le-am cântat și doresc tuturor românilor și la toată lumea, la mulți ani și deci primul cântec a fost Mulți ani trăiască, al doilea La mulți ani cu sănătate, cântec pe care formațiile îl cântă la fiecare la fiecare pari. Deci dacă e nuntă, dacă e botez, dacă e ziua de naștere la cineva, se cântă. Deci un cântec care nu lipsește de la pari respectiv, de la petrecere. Numai bine tuturor și la mulți ani.
Thank you, George. We loved having you.
Thank you. Thank you for inviting me here. Mm-hmm.